How does electricity reach our homes? It all starts from the power station, which gives a voltage of 20 kilovolts. But to transmit this voltage over longer distances, it is stepped up with the help of step-up transformer. The transmission lines carry this voltage to the substations or distribution stations, where the voltage gets transformed from 440 kilovolts to 11 kilovolts, which is safer for distribution. Again, the voltage gets decreased one or two steps with another step-down transformer before reaching our homes. So, basically, transformers step up or down the voltage before making its final way to the destination. But how it's done? The transformer usually consists of an iron core. The sides of the iron core are wrapped up with a coil, termed as primary winding and secondary winding. While for a step-down transformer, the primary winding has more turns than the secondary winding. Now, when a high AC voltage is given at the input, it excites the primary winding. After this excitation, alternating current circulates the winding and creates an alternating magnetic flux, which passes through the magnetic iron core. This alternating magnetic flux induces a voltage in the secondary winding. Since the number of turns in the secondary winding is less, the induced voltage will be low. So, without making an electrical contact, the voltage in the primary winding is transferred to the secondary winding. Simultaneously, for a step-up transformer, number of winding turns in the primary winding is less compared to the secondary winding. In our daily lives, transformers are everywhere, from the utility provider lines to the mobile phone chargers. In this case, it steps down in a small amount, nothing but incoming voltage reduces to 5 voltages for charging your mobile phones.